Happy Friday. I am Kim Kesty here in the Creative Classroom, coming to you for another fun Tri-Day Friday. And I figure, you know what? September is the month about fall. To me, that's when all the pumpkin spice comes out and all the other good things. So we're going to be doing some fall projects today, and I'm going to go through them real quick. I am using the brand new collection called Happy Harvest by Nicole Spohr. So let's take a look at her four SKUs that she has. Now, I'm not going to be using all four of them today, but you are going to fall in love with all of them. So this is the Scare a Crow die set, and that's the main one I'm going to be using today. So cute. And then here we've got Welcome Fall. I'm going to flip this over just real quick because she has such darling projects on the back that Nicole herself created. So look at that with the little pumpkins and the leaves and the little barrel. And then this last one's called Wagon Full of Fall. And you can see that, of course, that makes a darling wagon. And you can put all the cute fall things inside. Maybe even sneak a little bit of your pumpkin spice in there too. And last but not least is a fun stamp set. So this is going to coordinate with all three die sets and just mix and match. You are going to have a blast doing that. So I might bring them back in as I go along, but I really just kind of first want to just talk about this darling little scarecrow, and I've got him mostly assembled. I'm going to be adding a few little things as we go along, but look, here's his little crow friend, his little hat. So all the pieces are just super fun. Nicole herself actually just did a really great video. If you are on some of the social medias following Nicole, you're definitely going to want to check that out because she walks you through a lot of the little tips and tricks that she has. So what I've done here is I've kind of assembled most of the scarecrow. I'm going to add a little bit more hair here tucked underneath his hat. And then I want to show you a little tip that Nicole actually did on her original projects. And then she's also kind of shared that tip on her videos. Just putting a little dot of glue here so I can add his little straw. Is this what scarecrows are made out of? Straw or hay or what? I don't actually know the real proper way to make a scarecrow.
Didn't you watch The Wizard of Oz, Kim?
The Wizard of Oz? What is it? Is it straw?
Straw.
Straw, okay. Straw. Well, I said straw. I thought it was straw.
Which came at him with fire.
Well, hay burns up too, doesn't it? I don't know.
It does. It could be either, actually.
Oh my gosh. So kind of the little trick to adding a whole lot of character to this little guy is once you've got your die cut pieces in place, and like I said, this is something that Nicole did, you take a little marker or you take some ink or a watercolor, anything you want, and just kind of add a few little accents. So this happens to be a Copic marker, and I'm just coming in and just not really coloring all of the straw, now that I know it's straw, I'm just adding a few little highlights. You can see I've already done that on the cute little hands and feet for the pumpkin guy, for the scarecrow guy. I'm gonna do it for some pumpkins too. I cut out a lot of pumpkins. I thought they were so darn cute. And actually, now that I'm kind of working with finishing my card, I don't actually know if I'm gonna be doing all of these pumpkins on my card, but if I don't, I'll have them for another card, right? So again, just coming in with the marker and just doing just a few little edges, you know, just adds a little fun highlight. So that's kind of my tip of the day for starting that guy out with. Now I know I am going to use some corn stalks because you know what? That is what Mr. Scarecrow is all about, guarding the corn stalks. So again, I've kind of already glued in the little corn at the top. Now I'm just going to come in and put all my highlights on the left side of the little ear of corn. And then they'll all match and maybe it'll kind of look like the sun's coming across your card in a certain direction. So I've got little Mr. Scarecrow. I am going to take a little jelly roll, just white pen here. I'm going to make sure it's working. And just put a cute little highlight on his little eyes. That just makes them pop a little bit. One there and one here. Now that's going to take a second to dry. I don't want it to smear anything, so I'm going to set him aside. Right up there so his little eyes can dry. So what I've done for the base of my card is glimmered a fun little background. I'm going to be doing another video later on showing you how to glimmer on a few different kind of papers or substrates or surfaces or whatever you want to call it. So watch for that. But I've just got this great little border, and this is just one of our framed dual line borders. This is the glimmer plate right here. So just a very simple border. And then I cut another panel of paper I'm going to pop up here with some foam squares. And then I'll show you how I did the little hill. So I figure, you know, cornfield's kind of rolling, right? They got to have a little dimension. So if y'all are watching on YouTube, definitely consider subscribing to our YouTube channel, because we always have every week new videos, sometimes multiple times a week. Don't want to miss any of that. And of course you can check out our other social media too, on Facebook or Instagram. I just looked right, I was just talking about how I love things that are straight. I hate if they're a little bit crooked, and I feel like this is a tiny bit crooked. Let's just go up a little bit higher. There we go. Some of you'll be like, it looks the same, Kim. No, it's straighter, I promise. So I've also got a little trim of paper that I did here, and this is just a piece of brown cardstock. It wasn't necessarily a die cut or anything. I'm gonna add a little bit of ink to the side. This is just so I can have my scarecrow in action, right? He's gonna be kind of up on his little post. I'm gonna kind of determine where he goes. That'll help me place my corn in my field. But before I do that, after I had this card base done, I was like, I love all the little inking stuff on the scarecrow, so I wanted to add some inking to my hill, which, by the way, is created very simply with this amazing dye, which I get so much mileage out of. This is our Color Block Scenicscapes, and we'll put the link up there in the description, but this is such a powerful dye. I love using it. It's great for snow. It's great for any of your scenic scenes that you're doing, and of course you could layer it, you know, with a couple different hills, say cut another green one and add it there or whatnot, but I wanted to share how I so quickly, easily cut this hill. And then because I did just trim it, I have my piece here that I did, which I'm actually gonna use as a mask, because I decided last minute that this needs a little bit of inking on the hill. So I've got my Distress Oxide, this is Mowed Lawn. I'm just gonna add a little bit of Mowed Lawn edging to my hill here. I thought about doing a yellow hill, but I'm like, well, no, because this corn is still growing, right? It's not really harvested yet, so I figure it's still going to be kind of green. So there we go. Added the mask. That's not a huge difference. It's just a little bit darker there. Hopefully that shows up on the video just a little bit. I'm going to put my post down. I'll probably use some foam squares to get the actual scarecrow up, but I wanted the post first so that I know where to place all my little corn stalks. Alright, I'm going to place him temporarily here and then start adding my corn stalk. Oops, I feel like this should go down a little bit more. Go down. There we go. So this is why I wasn't sure I ended up using the pumpkins, because I feel like I did a lot of corn and I really want this to look like a full cornfield. So I'm just gonna start layering these guys in here. Some of them I have one stalk of corn, some I have two ears. And you can also see as I'm layering this on that I also cut them out of two different greens. So I used our rainforest cardstock and our fern. Just kind of doing a few different shades of green. Whoa, there's one with three corns of ears of corn. Quickly adding these on. And I don't mind if they're layered a little bit. I think that's fun too. Check and make sure he's not covering all of them yet. And then I thought it'd also be fun to add some to kind of a little bit more of the foreground. So I'm going to put these on the hill. It'll look like a very busy cornfield. So what are you guys thinking? Pumpkins or no pumpkins now that I have all these added on here? Maybe we'll have to do a quick poll. Quickly answer, pumpkins or no pumpkins? And the last one. It's so cute. I absolutely love this die set. I know that you guys are too, and I think it's actually right now kind of trending on our sales as being one of our top sellers, because seriously, who could resist? Cut one foam square in half. So we'll get our little scarecrow. We should come up with a name for him, right? I love the name of the die set, that it's Scare-a-Crow. I don't think he's too scary though, do you guys? feel like he's not super scary. Okay, one foam square there. I'm going to double up the foam square behind his head so he sits properly. So cute. And then last but not least, we do have to put his crow friend. By the way, I cut out the little basket from the other die set. And after I did, I was like, oh, no, I think it's too big. You know, once I kind of cut this panel smaller, I think that was too big. But let's take a little bit darker marker and put a few accents shading on our little crow here. Just kind of do around his edge. Do his beak a little bit darker, right? Because he should have a little shiny beak. Some accents on his little feet. And I'll probably come back with that white marker too and add a little accent. Well, this is the question. Where should our little crow friend be? I thought about shoulder, but as I started kind of working on the card, I think I'm just going to pop him in here because he's just hanging out with Mr. Scarecrow. They're friends.
He's not a very good scarecrow, is he?
I know. He's not a very good. He actually makes friends with the crows instead of scaring them. Put a little highlight on that little eye there. Okay, so I'm not sure if you guys voted already, but I am thinking I'm going to save these cute little pumpkins in this little basket for another project. If anything, I probably could pop in just a little small pumpkin here, but I don't know. I think it might be distracting to our little scarecrow. So I'm going to leave those off for now. Here's another little branch from one of Nicole's sets. And I'm just going to call this one good. So cute. Absolutely love him. Love the little pop of glimmer around the edge. It makes him so cute. I'll put him on a card base. Maybe I'll bring in some of the fun little red for the card base or something, or the orange, and finish that one up. We'll be sure to post this on the blog as we kind of post these videos a little bit later after the live show. I hope that you guys are going to have a great weekend crafting, that you're getting in the mood for fall and have yourself a little pumpkin spice and all those good things. And have a great weekend. We'll see you soon.